So these are the wells constructed in the forts. Puri Raja, whenever they wanted to construct their kingdom, okay, they constructed first wells or reservoirs. This is from Chittorgarh, Rajasthan. Chittorgarh is very huge, 7 layers of fort it is. Okay. चितोडगढ़ आठवण है कि नहीं कुछ पिक्चर मध्य आला राणी पद्मिनी खिलजी अलाउद्दीन खिलजी नाउ दीज आर दी आइलैंड्स इन महाराष्ट्र ऑफशोर आइलैंड्स वेयर दे हैव कंस्ट्रक्टेड वेल्स सम वेल्स हैव फ्रेश वाटर हियर हाउ डू दे ऑकर फ्रेश वाटर हियर Surrounding water is saline, whereas in the island we have fresh water. Okay, that is because of the availability of weathered zone in the island and rainfall. Whenever there is a rainfall during rainy season, this fresh water accumulates and floats on this saline water. So that's why we find fresh water or sweet water in the islands. This well is from Sindhudurg, Malwan. Okay, in Sindhudurg there are three wells. One is salty, one is intermediate, another one is sweet. Okay. Now these are called Kalyani wells. Very old, maybe in centuries old. Wherever there are temples, in front of temples also they have constructed wells. There can be small wells, there can be huge wells. You can see this one. This is from Shravanbelagola. This is from again Hampi. See the depth. Steps are used to reach the bottom to fetch the water during dry season. Okay. So zone of aeration, zone of saturation, you all know. Zone of aeration depends upon the weathering zone, and zone of saturation depends upon the aquifers. Okay. Now during dry season, the water table is quite far away down. Okay, depth is quite far. That's why we require in summer to dig wells for drinking purpose and domestic purpose. So people go for wells and bore wells. Now bore wells, wells are shallow wells, open wells. They go up to 50 to 60 feet, whereas people have gone for bore well because of the saturated zone has gone quite far. Especially in Maharashtra, people have gone for more than 2,000 feet, 2,000 to 3,000 feet. Okay. So during monsoon season, the zone of saturation is filled with water. The water table rises above. During monsoon season, wells. So whenever we want to drill a well or dig a well, we need to check the surrounding for feasibility, whether the groundwater table is shallow or deep. So for that reason, we require to consult the surrounding people, okay, so that we come to know some knowledge about the depth of water table. Certain cases where we don't have any people, but we need to drill a well or dig a well, then we need to see the surrounding and try to identify these bio information signatures. For example, bushes, thorny food bushes, these are called broom gases, grasses. There are thorny trees. This is ficus, which are very important for identification of groundwater. There are indications given by the termite mounds also. If you have more termite mounds, definitely there is a shallow water table, because termite needs soft clay, and that clay is brought by these termites and build. So these are the indications of groundwater. There are trees, the tree canopy is very close to ground. Okay, they are spread widely. Instead of vertical growth, they grow horizontally. So these are the indications of bio indications of some water tables in areas, especially dry areas. We need to look for these trees. Okay, so thick, the rock types, especially sedimentary rocks, inclined rocks, horizontal rocks, okay, igneous, we need to check fractures, joints, okay, in metamorphic rocks, foliations, again joints and fractures. We need to look for dikes, lineaments, that is huge fractures, or troughs, folded regions, fault lines, etc. These are the secondary structures, primary structures. We need to be very careful while delineating or detecting the water wells. Often existing wells in close proximity indicate the presence of groundwater. Existing wells also, we need to survey what is the depth of the water table. That will give you an idea how far is the water table. If technical equipment is available like geophysical and seismic surveys, we can give detailed information on the groundwater level. That is resistivity. You have already studied resistivity with Suresh sir and Yogesh sir. So these are the structures. We need to be careful whether to identify weathered zones, fracture zones in igneous rocks, joint planes. You can see this joint, huge joints. These are the caverns where they accumulate water. They are the sources of water, percolation, infiltration, accumulation, etc. You can see this, the water in the sedimentary rocks. These are the layered rocks where the fractures have given path to the groundwater. Okay. Folded regions, faulted regions, jointed regions. So water percolates inside and accumulates as groundwater. Even in columnar joints, basaltic rocks. Basaltic rocks are impermeable, but if there are columnar joints which run hundreds of feet down, they also can accumulate or allow the water to percolate inside. You can see these fractures. In quarries also serve as infiltration wells. These are the metamorphic rocks where joints, foliations, can see the water seeping inside. These are the dikes. Along the dikes also you can see the water moving inside, and you can see the accumulation of water, and there are caves formed because these rocks, okay, are softer than the dike. So along the dike plane, the water enters inside and creates a void or caves. So this is a dike. Now whenever the rainfall falls here on the both sides, the water cannot move from the dike or through the dike, this side or either side. So the water moves always on the either side. So there is no cross through or trespassing. So people can drill well here and drill well here. Okay, if the strata is inclined, okay, if the strata is inclined, then the opposite side you may not get water if there is a dike. So dikes are very important for location of wells. Now in case of joints, some joints are interconnected, some joints are non-connected. Okay, here whenever there is a interconnected joints, if you drill a well and if you are lucky, if you can contact these joints, then you are getting water. So first figure you can see, it's a good well. And if you are unlucky to tap these joints, and if you go for drilling where there is no joints, then the well can be dry. Okay, and if you see this third one, if you, again unfortunate, even though you have those joints, but you drill where, and if you end where there is no joint, then you might have little water. Here we have sufficient water. Okay. So joints are very important. For wells and bore wells, wells are holes in the ground that intersect groundwater and enable groundwater to be brought to the surface. These holes are dug by hand or by drilling machine. So people here nowadays, we drill open wells with hand. We hire some people and dug wells up to 40 to 50 feet. But beyond that, we require drilling machines. Wells of the hole usually supported either by bricks, pipes, etc. These walls of the wells need to be protected, okay, because some rocks or some soils are, they swell whenever they are wet, they become swell, they give rise to swelling effect, so the wall can collapse. So to protect these walls, we require to construct these walls by bricks, rocks, or even nowadays we use pipes, cement pipes. The depth depends on aquifer type and available yield. Again, the aquifer is very important. If you have good aquifer, you will have good source of water. Otherwise, less source of water. So geology is very important. Types of rocks. Now, two main types of wells we can see around, that is dug wells and drill wells, bore wells. Dug wells are open wells, usually plus or minus 1.2 meters. Length can be 20 meters up to, in shallow water level, groundwater table, we might go up to 3 meters and at even up to 50 meters, depending upon the zone of aeration. Now, if you remember in, if anybody lives in Bhagyanagar area, about 10-15 years back or 20 years back, we used to collect the water by hand in the open wells. So that was the groundwater table. Nowadays, it has reached up to 35 to 40 feet. Drilled wells are bore wells, which are driven by machine drilling. And diameter will be plus or minus 50 mm. Depending upon the requirement, then 10 to 50 meter depth up to 200 meters. These are the open wells. Sometimes some people, if they lack the water, they even drill horizontal tunnels inside, shafts. Okay. So these are the construction of cement pipes or construction of walls to protect the wall, wells of the wall. Now, drilling techniques, how do we drill? By hand, by again rotating, or drilling. Groundwater withdrawal from wells by all these methods. Shallow well, hand dug, unconfined water table, aquifer, unconfined. Remember, unconfined and confined water tables. Groundwater recovered by hand or low rate suction pump. We require for open wells to retrieve the water, we sometimes use hand or sometimes use low rate pumps. Deep wells, these are machine drilled. Confined and unconfined aquifers are punctured here, both. Confined aquifers are quite deeper compared to unconfined aquifers, and again depends upon the aquifers. Groundwater required recovery by pumps. They are called jet pumps. Well installation methods, we have hand excavation or boring. Hand drilling include augering and jetting. Machine drilling, rotary, percussion, downhole hammer. Drilled wells reach greater depths, penetrate wider range of rocks. Sometimes they go even up to kilometers, drilling wells like petroleum drilling, etc. Hand completed wells, we have hand augering, a small hole, install narrow casing tube well. Especially we use where the rock formations are very soft, especially sandy deposits or loose sediments like river beds. Hand digging larger diameter, Okay, sometimes we require larger diameter, more than 1 meter. Ground must be soft enough to penetrate. Shallow water table is required. Whenever there is a shallow water table, we require this hand auguring method. So likely in the very first phase of an emergency, equipment can be mobilized quickly, produced from available materials. This is the application of hand completed wells. Relatively low cost, the cost is very less. Often local expertise is available, labors are available. Can be labor intensive. Sometimes we require 8 to 10 days if you have more labors. Otherwise it may go up to a month also for drilling or digging a well. The shallow hand auger wells. So these are called as hand auger. Augering, especially sand beds where river beds are there, you have shallow water tables. So in such cases, we require such augers. Okay, soft sediments. Dug wells, excavation is done manually with pick and shovel. Lining is most often necessary to protect the well from collapsing and preventing subsequent contamination of the well. So this wall lining is very important to protect the water by contamination. So materials required for lining is prefabricated concrete rings, stones, bricks, masonry, etc. Okay, this is the section how construction is made. These are the cement linings. Completion of hand dug wells. After completion, you can see this protection wall. They construct the cement surface to protect infiltration of unwanted water or contaminated water. You see those animals, etc. Okay. So you see now these are the you can see everywhere. Okay, to protect the borewells or wells surroundings. So bore drillings. Drilling equipment and technique is affected by rock types. Sometimes if the rocks are very hard, we need to go by drilling methods. Where depth of groundwater is very high, aquifer pressure, cost is high, chances of tapping water depends on the expertise. Now, whenever we go for drilling bore wells, we require to have good knowledge of groundwater or geology of that area. That's why people ask geologists for detecting the water. Okay. Use water pressure forced down a drill pipe through a nozzle to penetrate the soil. Need a source of water and pump to provide the pressure. Sometimes during drilling, we need to send water or even soil so that the drilling goes smoothly. This is jetting techniques. Jet is they send water jets. Machine drilling, advantage and disadvantages. It can reach great depths. It can penetrate wide range of rock types, whether it is hard or soft, can produce high yielding wells. Disadvantage here, one more advantage is space. Disadvantage is expensive, quite expensive. It goes up to 100-150 rupees per feet drilling, or sometimes more. It require highly skilled crews, can have long lead time from setup to completion, maybe private or government owned and not available for an emergency. Okay, some nowadays we require to take permission by district commissioner. And there are rules within 500 meters, you should not have other bore well. Okay, so these are the advantages of drilling bore wells. Percussion rigs crushes the rock under the weight of a tool dropped down the hole on a length of cable. Sometimes these tools are tied to a cable and they are thrown from top so that there is a suitable fracture in the rocks or cutting of the rocks. Suitable for unconsolidated and soft formation. It is not suitable for hard rock terrain. And the process is relatively slow. Now rotary rigs, what we have today, drilling machines, they can drill up to great depths, 1,000+ meters. Drill bits attached to the end of a segmented string of steel drilling rods. These drill bits are made up of diamonds, studded diamonds. As the drilling rod rotates, the bit grinds through the soil and rock. Air, water, or drilling mud used as a circulation fluid to remove cuttings of rock and soil. So these are the drilling machines. If time permits, I'll show you those videos. So constructing a well, in most drilled wells, the walls need to support. Again, we use plastic pipes, PVC pipes. Earlier, we used to have iron pipes, which are perforated in the weathered zones. Wells are cased with lengths of cement pipes sometimes. If the borewell is wide, they use cement pipes. Otherwise, we use PVC and iron pipes. These are called as casing pipes. Holes in very strong rocks, sometimes not cased. Hard rocks, for example, in granite and basalts, we may not require casing because they are very hard. There is no chance of collapsing of these holes. Opening the well to the aquifer. Cased wells need to have a screen to allow water to flow from the aquifer into the well. These casings, they have perforations so that the weathered zone, the soil should not collapse. Only the water can come inside. These screens are a length of slotted or perforated pipes, typically PVC, steel or stainless steel. Screens often have a filter pack to improve inflow to the well. Wells drilled in stable rock sometimes are not cased and have no screen, termed open hole. Okay. Now this is how drilling can take place. Perforated screens, casing. Now gravel, weathered zones need to be packed by gravels and other materials so that unwanted water should not go inside the borewell. That is contaminated water. Okay. So that is how casing is done. This is cross section of a borewell. Okay, this is called grouting. The top weathered zone is maintained, protected, okay, by grouting, cementing, so that polluted water cannot enter in the borewell. Okay, once if the water, polluted water goes inside, then the entire groundwater can be contaminated and which cannot be purified, whatever means. So once it is lost, it will be lost forever. So summary, we have dug well, we have gravel packed well, open hole well, dry well. Okay. These are aquifers, aquitard, confined aquifer, fractured rock. Okay. So types of water well, we have open well, tube wells. Open well depends on the nature of groundwater formation to be tapped. Open well in unconsolidated formation, open well in hard rock formations, dug wells in hard rock formations, dug cum bore wells in hard. So we have both options, dug wells as well as drill wells. Open well in unconsolidated, they can be unlined wells. For example, in villages, nowadays they use unlined wells. These are seasonal. Okay, once the season is over, they close those wells. Again, next season they open. Especially villagers, they know. They are, in Kannada, they call kai bavi, hand wells. Wells with pervious linings. Okay. Wells with impervious linings, dug cum bore wells. Now, tube wells, we have based on entry of water, screen wells, cavity wells, based on method of construction, drilled wells, driven wells, jetted wells. Based on depth, shallow wells, deep wells. Based on type of aquifers, water table wells, artesian wells, flowing artesian wells. So augering method, percussion method, jetting method, sludging method. Now artesian wells. Okay, we'll start. So artesian wells, we have studied already. What is artesian well? What is confined aquifer? What is unconfined aquifer? How this artesian well is operated? Where it is operated, etc. Okay. So confined and unconfined aquifer. Unconfined aquifer are open to surface, okay, which are protected by a layer of impermeable rock, okay, bottom. So the groundwater in adds up here and it is open, exposes to surface of the earth. Whereas confined aquifer, it is sandwiched between two impermeable rocks, okay. So this is aquifer. Suppose it's a sandstone and this is shale. Both are shales. So shale is a impermeable rock. Sandstone is a permeable rock. So whatever, whenever it starts percolating inside, it goes inside and starts flowing against the gravity, okay, towards the gravity. And when it is stopped by, suppose there is a dike, or there is a fault, so suddenly there is a change in the rock formation, the water starts accumulating in that aquifer, confined aquifer, and because of addition of water from the surface and there is no movement outside, the water starts having under pressure, getting pressure. This is called hydraulic pressure, and it is tremendous. Whenever we puncture this aquifer, confined aquifer, there is a sudden gush of water like fountain, okay, until the pressure is diminishes. That is called as artesian well. Okay, now here one more picture I have shown here. This is while going to Jog Falls near Siddhapur. Okay, you can see the water gushing out. So this is aquifer, confined aquifer, and it is under hydrostatic pressure. Here also you can see continuous flow of water without any instrument or equipment like pumps, etc. The water is coming out, oozing out. This is also confined aquifer. Artesian well, the pressure. See the pressure, tremendous pressure. This is due to hydrostatic pressure. So this is how augers are used. This is called auger. Okay, at the edge, these are angular cutting edges. When we rotate, it goes inside the soil and creates a hole. So this is required for shallow depth water tables and where unconfined means consolidated sediments are there, especially loose sediments like river bed, sand beds, or soil deposits. In such cases, they use these augers. These are called hand augers. This is another picture of artesian well. This is near Ramtirth. Some 2 years back, one of my friend had dug a borewell Let's see. In fact, they are very lucky to have such artesian wells. Continuous water they'll get 4 to 6 inches. This one, same near Ramtirth. This is animation how bore wells or wells are drilled. This is weathered zone. Casing pipe. Rock formation. This is jet pump. In foreign countries, we require permission from government. You cannot drill wherever you want, like India. Nowadays, here also, government is making strict rules, but still, bribing and other things goes, and people drill wells, forgetting all those rules. Okay, these are sinkholes. Sinkholes are natural caverns in the limestone regions or calcareous region or carbonate regions. Okay, these sinkholes are huge water storages. You can see these lakes. Okay, see the top surface, and this is huge cavern, caves. Kettle holes in glacier regions, sinkholes in karst topography, etc., natural wells. These are called as Keni. Keni rivers, Keni wells are well known in Kerala. These are again hand-driven wells. They are shallow wooden abstraction structures built in the soil zone where the water table is shallow. Especially these wall linings, sometimes they are made up of coconut branches or stumps. You can see this figure. Okay, araucanut and coconut tree trunks. Some nowadays they are protecting them with wall linings. Otherwise, earlier they used to have those wells. These are called as Keni wells. Okay. These are traditional wells used for water harvesting and purification, especially Kerala. Now, these are called as Kerais system. Kerais system, usually they are in desert. You can see this is the water table. And this is the slope of the area. They have this mother well, then access shafts. Okay, likewise, they have driven many shafts. Okay, and this will be the outlet where there will be a either lake or pond, etc., connected. Similar, these pictures are shown here in the photograph. Okay, these are tunnels where water is transported through these tunnels. Okay. Horizontal tunnel, shafts. So water is very important for survival in arid regions, especially in dry deserts. It is more precious than gold. In 6th century BC, these Kerais systems are very old, century old. When India was heralding a spiritual renaissance, the inhabitants of arid Iran were busy building canal and Kerais system to tap deep alluvial aquifers and channel the water along underground tunnel, often over kilometers. You have seen those figures using gravity. Canal is the Arabic word for channel, and canals in Persian are called Kerais. These are Persian and Arabic words. In 15th century, when Bidar in northeast Karnataka became established center and capital of Bahmani dynasty, the Kerais system was successfully introduced, and it was borrowed from these Persians and Arabians. Picturesquely perched on the ridge of Deccan Plateau, Bidar has rich laterite formations, porous rock that allows for optimal groundwater recharge while also serving as purifier. Laterite formation is around Bidar. The upper crust of the plateau is of laterite, a soft porous rock with limonitic surface. Water filtered during the monsoon through the lateritic stratum is arrested, and a nursery of springs is formed. The Kerais system is built along a geological fracture. Such fractures are formed at the intersection of laterite and basalt rocks and form lineaments. And these lineaments are tapped for this Kerais system. The Bahmanis had their roots in Iran. The water supply to Bidar Fort and its surrounding also used Kerais system introduced by Iranian masons. So these Kerais system in Bidar were brought by these Iranian masons through Arabs and Persians. So these locally are called as Surangbavi. The length of these Kerais can range up to 3.5 to 4 kilometers. So that ends today's talk on wells and types of wells.